5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Hi there, this is Barry from cncmodeler.co.uk and today we're going to look at the Iroda Micro Therm. And we're going to look at two things. One is just a general teardown, and the other one is I had problems with this in terms of it wouldn't ignite. And I'll show you what I did to sort that out. So since I think the most useful bit of this is sorting out why the microphone wouldn't ignite, as you can see possibly in there, there's a mesh. So what I came to the conclusion of was that this mesh got clogged up with soot. So all I did to fix the problem, remove this screw, obviously when it's cold, not when it's hot, because you will burn yourself. If you take this away very gently, you should leave a stack in terms of, okay. So yeah, so you've got two pieces of mesh on top of the burner. You know, that mesh. So, well, I had two pieces of mesh, one with a hole in it, and one solid. So the one with a hole in it goes underneath, and then if we put that down for a second, we also got inside here is a tiny little ring. Again, see that. And that sits in the nozzle to just give something to pinch the mesh down onto the nozzle with. So all I did to get mine working again properly was I took these out, and as you can see there's a, well, you may be able to see there's some dark areas on there that it is starting to sit up again a little bit. So I took them out, I just used a little bit of abrasive, which is generally just try to clear it out, get rid of the soot. Then I put these back on here, like that. Then put your ring on top after that, making sure the piece of gauze with the hole, piece of mesh with hole, is on the bottom next to the burner. And see where the hole is for your thing, the cover, and you just slide it over. Have a quick look, make sure everything looks okay. If it does, you may or may not be able to see that. You can see the ring on top of the gauze. And then reinsert your screw. Oh, let me drop that. As you can see, a little tricky. There we go. And all being well, when I do this, there you go, you can see the glow. So there you go. So that's how, if your microtherm is not igniting, just take the nozzle cap off when it's cold, and just clean up those two pieces of gauze. When you replace the gauze, make sure that you put the piece of gauze with a hole closest to the gun side, and then she should work again. Okay, so that's the fix for it not igniting. We'll move on now to disassembly. So the bottom comes off like this, and then here you have what's effectively a disposable lighter without the striker. That's your gas cartridge, and then we have this. So you probably can't see very much in there, but there are some gubbins in there, so we'll just open the case. Now, the reason I have done this before is because I dropped it, and the trigger came dislodged. Let's try a different screwdriver. Now, if we gently separate the case lid, you can see what's in here. So, you have the trigger mechanism, which we'll take apart further in a second. Okay. You have a little spring unit, and then you have a little igniter unit here. You have the gas nozzle that goes into the pipe that goes into there. There's the lead that comes down for the igniter unit. And then the reason, as I said, I took this apart, so you have on here, you have the slidey lock, which is integral to that, but you can just clip off. There's an axle that it pivots on. And there's this little piece here. Now, if you can see, I'll take it out actually, so you can see the correct orientation of this piece, which is the piece that came loose, is that way. So that goes in there like that, and this shoulder here. Over there sits nicely over the back of this piece here. Okay. So in terms of if you ever have that piece come out like I did, basically to put it back together, you slide that in over there like that, you find the axle its home like that. And with those in place, you can then replace the cover. Redo the screws. Replace the cartridge, close the unit, and again, there we go. So there you go, the Iroda Micro Therm, two little fixes, basically the nozzle, you take it apart and you clean the gauze, and the trigger assembly, if you dropped it and that stops working, then you just need to replace that little piece of metal into the trigger. There you go. This is Barry from cncmodeler.co.uk signing off. Bye.